told you I got you.
Resolution Sports, the number one source, breaking from football up to extreme sports. So come on and join the resolution. Join the resolution. So come on and join the
resolution. Well, all that is really hard to follow. First, I want to thank Sunil and Dan Flynn, U.S. Soccer, for everything you do. And Hank, you know, I'm still speechless, but they tell me I have to say something. So I appreciate everything from the Hall of Fame Induction Committee. It's an honor to be on this ballot for sure. I want to say thank you to everybody that voted. I'd like to personally congratulate Tony DeChico, a friend, someone who shares the same passion that I do in the goal. Desmond Armstrong, a great teammate. You will never be forgotten. But more importantly, Desmond was a guy who showed a lot of us at a young age what it was like to be a professional. So thank you. Claudio Reyna, a kid who I grew up watching. He came up through the ranks in New Jersey. I had the pleasure to be his captain in the 1994 World Cup. 8 years later, I had the honor of being on the 2002 World Cup team that Claudio was the captain of. Today, our thoughts and prayers are with Claudio and his family for sure. Being part of the Hall of Fame was never a mission of mine growing up. Quite honestly, I didn't know what it was. I didn't know what it meant to an athlete. When I eventually learned more about it, I had no idea how to get there. I was just a kid doing what I loved to do, playing soccer in Kearney, New Jersey, trying to follow in the footsteps of great players like John Harkes and Tab Ramos. Now that I've reached this point, I find myself honored and humbled by this entire experience. As I began preparing for today, I was able to reflect back on so many great things that have happened in my life and all the great people that have been in my life because of the sport of soccer. I'm forever indebted to so many of you. I could never fully repay you, but I will try today in just a small way. Every athlete gets motivated in different ways. For me, the thrill of coming out for warm-ups and seeing the stadium begin to fill up and know that when you got out there, the stadiums would be full with fans just was a high for me that I could never explain. So I want to thank all the fans that for so many years supported me, encouraged me, and pushed me to want to be better. I especially want to thank the fans of Kansas City that for 7 years of my life gave me and my family more support. Believe me, it's not easy for a kid from New Jersey to move to Kansas City. And I'm honored to have shared an MLS Cup as well as a Lamar Hunt Open Cup with you, and it's something I'll cherish forever. I also want to thank, obviously, the fans in the New Jersey area for your support and your passion of the game for so many years. Even though the job was never finished, it goes without saying that I wanted to win a championship in my hometown more than anyone. And although that mission still remains the same, I want to say thank you for the memories. You will always be my home crowd for sure. I want to thank the media, by whom I was always treated fairly for 20 years of a professional career. Thank you for fighting for media time, for fighting for space in newspapers, especially in the early days, as Paul mentioned, when no one seemed to want to cover our game. every athlete has their first interview at some point, and we do thousands of them over the years. Mine came, I still remember it, and it came in 1987 in Rio de Janeiro on a bus ride back from a youth national team game that we just lost against Brazil. And for that experience, I want to thank Michael Lewis, who I know is here somewhere today, for being part of that and continuing his support of our sport. As a player, your greatest wish always is to go to a stadium and know that you have a great organization, great coaches, and great teammates. They either make or break your career. And in my case, I couldn't have been any more blessed. So to all the coaches, I've learned something from each and every one of you. Hopefully I didn't drive you, I know Coach Ganser will probably disagree, but hopefully I didn't drive you crazy along the way trying to convince you that I was a center forward. I'm just trapped in this goalkeeper's body. Okay. John Miller, who I know is here somewhere today, Michael Russick, my high school soccer coaches, who taught me what it meant to be a part of a winning program at Kearney High School at such a young age. To my high school baseball coach, Jimmy Sanfilippo, who drilled into my head the one saying that I never let escape me my entire career. That saying was simple, but for me essential if I was going to be successful. And that saying was, winners win. Thank you, Jimmy. And there are so many coaches in my career that have influenced this path to get here today. Bora Milutinovic, my 1994 World Cup coach, Afonso Mondello, Ralph Perez, John Kowalski, Dave Sarakin, and Bob Bradley, who gave me an opportunity to come back to New Jersey at the end of my career to play. To my goalkeeper coaches, especially Tim Mulqueen and Milutin Sholey-Soskic, we shared the love of the game on a daily basis. We worked for so many hours together just for the same goal. I appreciate your support and thank you for pushing me when I didn't think I could dive again. I share this with you. To Coach Gansler, my coach in the 90 World Cup, and for those two championships in Kansas City, and the first coach to believe in me and give me a chance with the national team, thank you. excuse me. And lastly, Bruce Arena. My career, as most people know, started and ended with Bruce. It also had a lot of great years and great memories in between. He taught me so much about the game of soccer when he brought me to the University of Virginia, where he treated me like a son, all the way through the national team, where he allowed me to earn my 100th cap with the national team, where he treated me like a man. Thank you, Bruce, and thank you to your family. Most athletes never really get a chance to be part of an organization with an owner that cares more about your family, your personal life, and your character, seemingly more than he does about any of the results that you've ever had. I played for one owner like that, who had a profound... had a profound effect on myself, excuse me, and everyone in our locker room. I'm sorry. He always warned me not to use his name because it wasn't about him. I would be remiss if I didn't recognize the impact on my life the late Mr. Lamar Hunt . He was a gentleman, a role model in every sense of the word, and through his actions he taught us all about humility. Thank you for your lessons and your support, Mr. Hunt. To my teammates, after 20 years of playing, there's so many to name. I want to say thank you to all of you. 16 of you that I will forever share a spot in the Hall of Fame. And surely there are so many more to join in the future. I enjoyed every minute we spent together trying to figure out how to win games. Most of the names you know, and here are a few: Agus, Balboa, Clavijo, Dooley, Doyle, Eichmann, Henderson, Johnston, Jones, Kinnear, Klein, Lawless, Masoner, Max Moore, Molnar, Murray, Perez, Preki, Savarese, Stewart, David Vanoli, Vermees, Windischman, Wijnaldum, Zavagnin. And then, of course, there's those who push me every day. Jurgen Sommer, Zach Thornton, Brad Friedel, Casey Keller, and Tim Howard. And of course, my two Kearney Thistle teammates, John Harkes and Pena Ramos. There are also some names you won't recognize, but helped mold my career as much as any. Arena Mullins, Monroe, Galco, McCord, O'Neill Gutierrez, and of course, Sal Rosamilia. Thank you for your help and your support. I also want to thank a special group of boys. They're a current U15 soccer team. Players that I've had the pleasure to coach for the last 5 years. It's a bit scary, and I know I spoke to Hank about this a while back, but when I didn't have a place in the game, there was a few months in my life where I wanted nothing more than to walk away. And I had the opportunity to coach an 11-year-old boys team that included my son, Jonathan. That group of boys gave me more reasons to love this beautiful game than I ever imagined existed. Thank you for the opportunity to coach you. Finally, this will be easy. I want to thank the most important people and special people in my life. My mom, Maria, my dad, Vincent, my sister, Angela. Talk about being there from the start. I can never, ever repay you for what you've done. Thank you for everything. The best way I think I can think of for repaying you would be to pass along the lessons that I've learned from you onto my own kids. Thank you, and I love you. During my career, there were so many highs and so many lows. There were days when things were headed in the right direction, and there were things when it was just a bad day. But when I would open the door, there was one thing that was for sure that made me smile, and that was my kids. So to Jonathan, Kylie, and Aiden, I am proud of you and the people you are becoming. Like I always tell you, you can do whatever you set your mind to. I'm your biggest fan. And last, but not certainly least, in order to be successful, everyone needs a rock in their life. Someone who can deal with the pressures, the ups, the downs, and make sure the kids are taken care of and the family is in order. My wife, Colleen, is my rock and the love of my life. I love you more than words can explain. Like Desmond, you are my legacy. So thank you for always being there for me. I love you. I want to say thank you. It's a great honor, and it is my pleasure to be part of this entire class and the rest of the Hall of Fame. Thank you very much.